Some of the more observant and astute amongst the viewing several, when looking at the pure heroine reaction, might have noticed there was a bit of an omission, an oversight, as far as one of the tracks is concerned. So, to all who noticed and were affected by that,
Sorry, I missed it.
but we're going to make up for it right now. Cue part of the thing. So yeah, track four, Ribs. I don't know what happened there. I just skipped it and I didn't realize. I have no excuse. So I'm going to make up for that today. And let's check it out. Track four from Lord Pure Heroine, Ribs. Very atmospheric beginning. Building to something. What are we building to?
Drink you spilt all over me.
I knew it was going to drop out a bit rather than explode, but still. Cheeky, really. Having all these really quiet, strange, mellow moments, and then hitting us with that in the chorus. Something about that just from what I remember from the original album when I reacted to the rest of it. This feels just a shade more busy, like the layering of the vocals and the whole. There's a lot going on, I feel like, compared to some of the other tracks. I mean, it's good, but it just feels different. Yeah, that lyric, that laugh until our ribs get soft. That's a really interesting image. Yeah, I feel bad that I didn't catch that when I listened to the album the first time. Obviously, it would have slotted in beautifully along with the other tracks. I enjoyed the album overall, and like I say, this one definitely felt a bit more production-y, I feel like, unless I'm misremembering. But there's a lot more going on with the layering of the vocals, and just it just felt like there were more elements. Whereas some of the other tracks, from what I recall, were they relied a lot more on a very basic, not in a bad way basic, but fairly straightforward structure and beat and just her the atmosphere that was created and her vocals carrying the song through, usually. And just to broaden things a tiny bit, I felt like looking up another track of hers just to tag on here, instead of it just being the one track that I stupidly forgot to react to. So I came across a fun little cover that apparently featured in Catching Fire. I mean, I've seen that film 1.5 times, I'd like to say, so I probably just don't remember it. But a cover of a great song by Tears for Fears, Everybody Wants to Rule the World. So let's see what Lord does with it. Okay. Super pared down and way darker. It's my own desire. It's my own remorse. Nothing ever lasts forever. See, it's both pared down, but also has these those violent bangs and crashes. It's a really interesting choice. Okay, Lord, I see you. That's a very interesting take. I mean, it's hard to take away much from the original. The original is great. It's a great band. Iconic band of the 80s. But, yeah, she had a lot of... Maybe the phrase, having a lot of fun with it, doesn't quite fit, considering how dark and violent and just aggressive, yet... You know, the kind of aggressive when, instead of being yelled at, authority figure just lowers their tone. You know, there's more threat in the sort of creepy, slow nature of it. Punctuated with just those bangs and those crashes. That was cool. So yes, apologies again for not listening to Rib's first time round. I will be checking out more Lord, obviously. I think Melodrama will be the next thing I listen to, as far as she is concerned. Any other suggestions as far as other people I should check out? Results of the poll are in, so I will be doing more of a deep dive or exploring the back catalogue and what have you of Lana Del Rey, as well as other artists. We're going to be continuing on the Tay train, as well as one or two others. So yeah, thanks for watching as always. Goodbye forever.
Shut up! Will you shut up? Ah! Now we see the violence inherent in the system! Bloody peasant!